Good afternoon, Honorable Chancellor, Provost, Board of Trustees, colleagues, families, and graduates. It is my greatest honor and privilege to be with you today. Graduates, congratulations on achieving the most important milestone of your life. You have already built the foundation of your career castle with maximum protections, and we are proud of you. Let us give all graduates a big round of applause. Today's commencement is the beginning of a long journey. You have every tool necessary to build the superstructure of your castle. It is our moral duty to learn new ideas and technologies to solve emerging problems for the advancement of mankind. Let me mention an arguable story. In 1950s, the chairman and CEO of IBM quoted the Cambridge mathematician Professor Douglas, "All the calculations what would ever be needed in this country could be done on 3 digital computers." Today, there are about 20 billion personal computers in the world. These statistics signify the advances made in different fields such as agriculture, business, art, science, biology, and engineering. If we stop learning, the progress in these areas would stop as well. Irrespective to age, gender, social status, and ethnicity, we learn from each other. The learning starts at home, and mothers are the first teachers. Being on the Mother's Day weekend, let us show our utmost respect and gratitude to all mothers who sacrificed their lives for us. We learn from kids too. I will share a couple of personal learning stories. My wife and I have 2 boys who are 12 and 4 years old. They were here in the morning to support my wife's graduation. One evening, my elder son asked if I knew any coding language so I could help him to fix a bug of his coding. I responded yes, because I knew some coding languages such as Java, C++. He asked, "Well, can you then fix me to turn the sprite 30 degrees on the right and then move 10 steps?" I was confused as I had no idea why I have to move the soda pops. It is in the fridge. Later, I realized that he was referring sprites that is used for animation in a coding language called Scratch. After going internet googling some time, I was able to do my first Scratch project. I felt I accomplished something. I was so excited that I could not resist myself to make a post on my Facebook. Another day, he asked me to tell a good joke so that he can put it in his project. I told him a chemistry joke. Oxygen went on a date with potassium, which was okay. He said, "Dad, this is not an authentic joke." To please him, I said another joke. The CEO dropped a brownie on his calculator and he was accused of fudging the numbers. He said, "This is not original either." I told him, "Son, I do not know how to come up with a new joke. I do not know your coding language is Scratch." My younger son, he shouted, and said, "Dad, I know scars. I have a scars on my face. Look." And he was started scratching his face. Immediately, I looked at my elder son. I told him, "See, the joke is right there." And he said, "Yes, Dad, that is really authentic." And then we laughed out loud for a moment. In conclusion, the learning has no boundary. Together, we can learn and inspire each other and build our limitless castle. Thank you, and God bless.